program is brought to you through the kind support of the friends of That's What She Said. Support BCTV by visiting bctv.org/support.
It used to be great, now it's not so great, but it's still pretty great. Wedding. It used to have lights, then it didn't have lights. New, with LED lights. Pagoda. Did they really say that? They did not say that. Yeah, they did say that. That's what she said.
Just hear the sleigh bells jingling, jing, jing, tingling. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Down. It looks like the movie. All right, we keep going. We'll be right over here in a moment. We're just going to reform ourselves. Clearly a holiday extravaganza episode of That's What She Said. I am, as always, Jane Street. To my left.
Sheila. Sheila Harrington.
Ooh, look at that.
Yeah, look at that. It's fancy, right?
It's a very
I'm
long...
I'm kicking things up a notch.
Oh, it's green.
Oh, yeah, it's just better. Starting. Yeah, this is going to be fun. We'll see what I got by the end of the show, right?
And I'm Ellen Gallagher.
And I'm Martha Richardson.
Nicole Weaver.
Ha! Well, here we are. Oh, I'm so exhausted from that sleigh ride, I don't know where
we're going. That was exhausting.
It was.
All those trees we drove by.
Snow going everywhere.
Spent.
I don't know, the first smell was...
Well, this is our Christmas special, and, we thought... Something we should talk about is our wishes, and I wish that Martha would pour me a glass of that log.
That's good stuff.
But this is a time for thoughts and good thoughts and good feelings, and my wish is that all of you out there in TV land, as it were, have a wonderful 2000. Whoa!
So
don't. Excuse me, we're having a little...
Technical difficulties.
We're having a technical moisture difficulty over here. It's going to be that kind of show, folks. But I do hope that everyone, my wish to everyone out there is, and here, is that we all have a safe and happy 2014 and lots of love in our lives, because without love, what is there? So, knitting lady...
What's my Christmas wish?
Yes.
I just don't want it to snow. You know, I'm not a big Christmas
person. Well, it's too late for that.
Right, but I'm hearing there's going to be 70-degree weather coming up right around the corner. So, just at least for one day.
Well, that's
wonderful. Let's keep it for Christmas, I think.
All right. Yeah.
I think what I wish for most is that everybody would have someone that they love to be with on Christmas Day.
That's nice.
A good friend, family around them. Just someone to share the joy of the holiday.
That's wonderful.
Well, I think Christmas was a miracle, so I would like to have some kind of miracle to feed and shelter all the homeless children in this country, all over the world. It breaks my heart to think about them.
I wish for there to be more love in this world, and I also wish that in 5 months, I will give birth to a healthy baby boy.
Woo! Yay! All right!
It's a girl. Put her on the show.
Sorry, it's a boy.
He can visit.
Guaranteed. Put him in a pink blanket, no one will know.
I'll try.
Well, that's wonderful. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, my goodness.
Goodness.
You are a wonderful, you're going to be a wonderful mother, I know.
Oh, I hope so.
You'll have all these aunts.
That's right. That's right. He's going to be spoiled.
Time to make some buddies.
Well, I like that all of our wishes are for some form of love and companionship for everyone, because I think that's what we all want in our lives, and for those we love, just to have. Well, except for you, you don't want snow.
Just want good weather. And I want everyone to be in love.
You could care less about anybody else. You just don't want snow. All right. Well, we have to tell you that oh my goodness, what have I forgotten? Yes. I'm told I was too noisy on the last show, so I will try to be quieter with my paper. I'll keep it away from the microphone. You may call us. You may call in. We have take live calls here. It's phenomenal. Technology is just amazing. And that number is 610-378-0426. One day I will memorize that, but until then, 378-0426. And you can also tweet us. I have the Twitterer going. It doesn't work really well with the gloves, but we'll try it. At She Tweets to Me. So, but we have some exciting news for our January show, because we are monthly now. Yes. January, we're going to do a special broadcast from Papillon Brasserie in West Reading. And we're going to film there. We're not quite sure how we're going to set the thing up, but I'm looking at Jamie when you don't see me looking at the camera, because I'm trying to get some little cues from him as to what exactly I should say. But we are going to film the entire evening, and if you would like to be a part of that special guest list for that evening, I don't know what the price. Did we?
We don't have a price yet.
Okay, we don't have a price yet, but it'll be a prefix, and you can be part of television history, because we will be filming the entire episode through there. The number for Papillon, if you should wish to make a reservation and join us for that evening, is 610-376-0601. That's 376-0601. And it's going to be a smashing evening.
And which night are we doing this?
Oh! Well, yes, that would help. It's the glog. It's getting... By the way, Martha has made the most fabulous glog. She'll tell you about it in a little bit. Yes, it's going to all of our heads.
Not all of ours.
Some of us are drinking water. It is on January 10th, a Saturday. Interesting, that's the day before Jamie and his husband Kirk's anniversary. So we can celebrate that evening, too. We have a home viewer.
All right.
My goodness, a call already. Hello, welcome to That's What She Said. You're on the air.
Hello, and how is everybody there?
Wonderful. How are you?
I think I'm pretty wonderful, too, but I know you're all wonderful. I am always so happy to find this program on the air.
Oh, yay.
Well, we're happy to be found.
A special blessed and Merry Christmas to all of you, and especially to Martha.
Ah.
He knows my son, and I guess he's going to be talking to her soon.
Oh.
Martha's a wonderful person.
Well, she is.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, she is.
Fan.
And she knows my son, Craig. And I see you're having a good time there. What happened to the wine?
Well, we're having glug tonight, which is a whole combination of good alcoholic things.
You might as well take this opportunity to tell us what it is.
Glug is red wine and port wine and brandy, rum, orange peel, cloves and cinnamon, and it's all heated to warm the cockles of our hearts.
It's amazing.
It's a wonderful thing.
And it is warm.
Well, I wish I was there joining you. It sounds like you're all having fun. I just love all of you.
Thank you.
Blessed and Merry Christmas and the happiest of New Year's to you.
Thank
you.
And you can come and...
Martha from Craig.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Good talking to you. You can come and join us on January 10th at the Papillon. And I don't think this is working. I don't know. anyway. Oh, where are we? Oh, my goodness, yes. We have a special greeting from a member of the cast past. What? Oh, you look like you were... Gelman was trying to say something over there. So let's roll tape and have our special holiday greeting from an old friend.
Here with Kira at Kira's Christmas party. Hello, Kira.
Hello.
We miss you on the show.
I miss being on the show. And school is awesome, but it's not as fun as being on the show.
Indeed. And we would love to have had you live on the show.
I know.
But it didn't work out.
It didn't.
With work. I know, because you have work going on.
Mm-hmm.
You have school going on.
I do.
You have personal life going on.
Yes.
Is that it?
That's pretty much
that's it.
Christmas party. Ugly sweater party going on.
Ugly sweater party. It's a lovely ugly sweater.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's, you know, I like it. It's a little classy for an ugly sweater.
I think you
made it happen. Oh, thank you.
Anyway, we just wanted to say we loved having you on the show. You know you have an open invitation to come back anytime you want.
Thank you.
And can you give us like one bar of Have Yourself?
Sure. And though it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
We miss you.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, we love her so much. It's nice that she could send us her greetings. We thought it would be interesting to find out what everyone's special holiday tradition is. So, I had a thought, and I just can't remember what it was. So, if I scream while you're talking, just
well,
go.
How are you?
Holiday tradition, what?
Oh, with me first. Well, growing up, we would open up presents at our house in the morning, and then we'd always go over to my grandmother's house for dinner with all of my aunts and uncles. And my favorite holiday tradition is, I'm probably gonna cry, I'm sorry, hormones.
Aww.
But my favorite holiday tradition is mom and dad would sit up front and me and my sister Ashley would be in the back, and we'd play Christmas music the whole way, and my dad would have us sing because he loved to hear us sing, and we'd always have to sing The First Noel is his favorite song, so my mom and I would sing that, and then we'd sing a couple other songs, and that's just my favorite tradition, being with my family and singing together and having that good time. It makes me miss them a lot. So
I did remember what it was. Let me interject. We do have a lot in store for you tonight. Better singing than you heard at the top of the show. We have the lovely Julian Cephus and her sisters' group they now call Colorblind. They will be playing a little later, and I just wanted to get that in there so you didn't think that was the best entertainment you're going to get all night. So, Martha.
Well, from the time my children were tiny until they were no longer home for Christmas, and even now when they come home for Christmas, every Christmas Eve when they went to bed, even when they were in high school and it was early Christmas morning when they went to bed, there was always a pair of brand new warm pajamas on their bed for them to wear.
Aww, that's
cool.
Nice.
I like that. Yes.
Well, Christmas is all about traditions, all sorts of traditions. And one that has a national application is the Christmas Day Bird Count, which the Audubon Society has people do all over the United States to get an idea of how birds are doing. They're kind of a bellwether for the environment. And if their numbers are increasing, that shows that things are going pretty well. If they're decreasing, then maybe we have to pay more attention to the environmental situations. But we have our own bird count at our house. A couple of years ago, I started decorating two trees in the sunroom with just birds, bird ornaments. And for a while, it was just kind of something to enjoy. But now, when our little grandchildren come, every Christmas Day, we have our bird count to see if that environment is a healthy one. And I have to say, the numbers are diminishing, and I think it has something to do with two cats in the house who have been seen running around with feathers hanging out of their mouths. So we have to do something to clean up the environment, perhaps. But the cats stay.
Sheila, have you changed your heart any about the Christmas season?
You know, I have not. I have my own little tradition. You know, I do my Chinese food and
glug
movies.
From now on.
Glug. And you know, I'm digging the smell of this Christmas tree. Maybe I'll have to start that as a new thing. We'll see. We'll see.
You could be passive aggressive about it and get a Christmas tree and just cut it up into bits and it would still smell and then you could still hate Christmas.
That's right. I could, right?
That would be absolutely.
Knit some sachets or something with pine needles.
Well, speaking of the tree, that was a perfect segue. Thank you, darling. Ladies went out on an expedition and they hacked this tree down with brute strength and a little chainsaw.
mostly a chainsaw.
let's take a look at the trip to
Plow Farms.
Plow Farms. Roll the tape.
And welcome to Plow Farms. We're here on this chilly December day to meet one of the people who owns Plow Farms, Preston Eshelman, and talk a little bit about this great Berks County business. So first of all, I'd like to introduce you to Preston. Preston, how did your family get involved in the Christmas tree business?
There was a piece of ground purchased at one time that didn't lend itself well for a crop. Buy these trees cheap for a couple cents a piece, we'll plant them, we won't touch them for 10 years, we'll go back, cut them, sell them as Christmas trees, and we'll make $20, $30 a piece of them. It was a disaster. Everything, the weeds had taken over and stuff, and the next thing you know, that leads us to today. They tried it again, and now we're pretty well full nursery production. We farm right around 400 acres in the Berks and Schuylkill County areas, Chester County, and
that's trees.
Well, pretty well trees, yeah, and that brings us to where we are now. And we've been on this farm for six generations, and then this I would be about the third generation in the nursery business. 99% of the people that come to the Christmas tree lot are happy. It's the winter, you got Santa, and it's nice to interact with people, and it's just, it's really, really fun being here. It's a lot of, we're 7 days a week from Thanksgiving to Christmas, and it's a lot of work and a lot of long days and harsh conditions, but it really makes it worth it.
I first started buying my trees here 5 years ago when I got my house, and I've always bought them from Preston, and when I came here, he said, you gotta go with the firs. So that's what I get every year.
Yeah.
So let's go cut a tree.
Yeah.
Let's go get a tree.
Excellent.
Let's go.
Let's go.
You want to do this tree right here? Then we're like kind of in the middle.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, that's good.
That's good.
That's a Charlie Brown.
Yeah.
They all kind of look Charlie Brown to me.
Right? If there's one you know that's good, it's not going to make it.
They all look beautiful.
Yeah.
They do a great job.
Yeah, they do.
These ones are great too because they have all the snow hanging on them. And
yeah.
Like a lot of nurseries too. Our nursery, everything we do is hand trimmed. We don't use a machine.
You do that annually?
Annually, yeah.
What time of the year?
Late summer.
Okay. Take a great deal of skill and knowledge of trees to know where to clip?
Yeah. Repetition is the only way to... Repetition is the key to learning. Yeah. So when you do it a lot, you'll figure it out.
Yeah.
But it does take some experience.
Lily, you're such a silly puppy. Oh. Yeah. Right, let's cut this tree.
Let's cut this tree.
Who wants to cut the... Who's using the hands?
Everybody uses
this.
Hands.
Lily. Lily's gonna help.
Lily, excellent.
Lily's gonna.
Who wants to cut first?
Go ahead, Nicole.
There you go.
I'll start.
Nicole, go.
There we go. I found it.
Don't cut the irrigation pipe, please.
I've got needles up my nose. I'd like to add that I'm doing this in a dress. Okay, that was fun. Who's next?
Okay. And which angle?
No,
Nobody's yelling timber.
I think we have a while to go before this.
Yeah.
Lily.
Oh, Lily's fine.
She's just trying to help.
Yeah, she is.
Okay.
Martha,
do you want to be the one to bring it down?
Just remember, Martha, let the saw do the work. That's what my dad always said. Well, he held a beer and I sawed things. Martha, you're born to it.
Come here.
Hey. You want me to finish it with the saw? With the
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh my God,
so much easier.
Oh, Lily, cut
that's
it
how
out.
You do it.
Yay.
Let's go see that part.
Who's going to drag the tree back? Oh, not Preston.
Not me.
Not Preston.
That's an easy one.
Look at that.
There you go.
Ellen's got a tree.
Come on,
she's got Mona.
Come on, Lily.
Lily is trained to drag trees. Little back there we tied to her. And she...
Sled to her and bring me
back. Oh my God, Ellen's off to the races.
It puts all the topsoil right at the tree where it needs to be.
Three girl tree.
It is.
During the week, Monday through Friday, 12 to 7. On the weekends, 9 to 5. We have Santa Claus on the weekends, tractor rides, hot chocolate. Oh,
and trees that you can feel part of.
Yeah, and you're welcome to bring your pets, the whole family. My mom does a great job with a little Christmas shop where we sell neat little ornaments and everything. So we'd love to see you come out sometime.
Don't forget Plow Farms right off Route 10.
Easy to find, convenient to walk around.
Great
perfect.
People.
Is this another chicken joke?
Do you have is there a phone number, website?
We have a website, plowfarms.com, or you can call us at 610-856-7740.
Great. 7740.
Yep.
All right. Thank you so much, Preston.
Bye.
Bye.
We really did have a good time cutting down a tree, and hopefully most of you are also getting your homes decorated and enjoying all of the festivity that goes with this holiday. I'm going to make apologies to Irving Berlin and Bing Crosby because I have kind of done my own version of White Christmas, a song that I think is one of the most beloved of this holiday, and I just thought I could express some thoughts to that music. And so I'm going to ask Sid to play an introduction. By the way, this is our accompanist, Sid Watts, who we've enjoyed having with us. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, unlike any I've ever known. White with the purity of its chromatic symbolism, the pristine white of serenity in a natural world of balance and harmony, the simple white of sincerity in our love and trust, the peaceful white of a political world without animosity and aggression, the physical white of the absence of color, ending discrimination and embracing diversity. And the sparkling white is seen in the welcome of a smile. May your days be merry and bright. And may all our Christmases be white. Thank you.
That was lovely. Thank you so much. Oh, my goodness. Well, now we have a... coming up next, Julian Cephus. Come up here. Come up here. Do you need a chair or anything, or are you good standing? All right, here. I know you. I don't know your sisters. What are your sisters' names?
My name's Milan.
My name's Clint.
Cool. And they are colorblind, and they're going to sing Break Even?
Yes.
Yes. Is this mic good for them here? Fabulous. We're so organized on this show, it's just like, let me get out of your way.
Pieces, yeah.
Lovely. Thank you very, very much. And now, we're going to take our infamous wee break. Ooh. So, we'll be back after the break.
You're watching bctv.org. Be informed. Be involved. Be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For other stories and information, go to bctv.org.
Well, that was quite lovely. One more time, I think I should tell you that as we return from the break, that the number is 610-378-0426 for callers, and she tweets to me for tweeters. And now I'd like to send you a little holiday treat. Hit it, Sid. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay. From now on, our troubles will be miles away. Gather near to us once more. Through the years, we all will be together. If the fates allow, hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and have yourself a merry little Christmas. Thank you. Merry Christmas to you all. Thank you, my dear friend Sid. Sid Watts once again on the piano. And now I'm going to go back over here because I'm told that Sheila has a special surprise for us. So let me run over here again. Pardon me as I run in front of the camera.
So even though I'm somewhat of a Grinch, I still wanted to be sort of Christmassy and get everybody a little something something. So I have some surprises here for everybody. We can just pass it on down the line.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. Uh-oh. This I'm a little wound up in this one. There you are.
Indeed.
Oh, my stockings. I wanted to make something this year. It just didn't work out.
Here she made the most wonderful little knitted stockings, and mine is hanging on my door.
Yes.
Excuse us while we open our presents.
For the tree, I figured I'd bring some anyway. Perhaps I can use them
for your birds, right?
Hello. And I've got one here for Jamie too.
It's so
And a candle.
Christmas cookie candles. Excellent.
Thank you, dear.
You're welcome, my darling.
You're welcome.
And one of these days, I'll get it in here to make new. That's what she said. Glasses that don't fall apart.
I still use mine, and it rocks, but I like
too,
it. But I don't care if it rocks. I love it.
Yeah, it doesn't say that's what she said anymore.
Aww.
I love this bird. Oh, I forgot the Christmas. Anyway, I brought a Christmas.
A Christmas.
A Christmas.
Christmas.
Oh, well, hold on. Here. Okay. Hold that. Talk amongst yourselves while I go get the Christmas.
I'm dying to know what this Christmas is. Here we come. Look at that.
Oh, Christmas.
It's Christmas.
Oh, cool.
You can sit with the bird, keep it company.
Oh, he's probably had too much
right in the cookie. Oh, much love.
Stack some cookies
up,
behind
me. Yeah, give that moose a cookie.
Oh my goodness. Okay, well, we should move this along. Now, I've been waiting for this since I first heard about it. We are told that Martha has a Christmas joke. So, I now present Martha and her Christmas joke.
Well, actually, this is a true story. I have a friend who is a nun, and her name is Sister Mary Alice, and she teaches at a parochial school. She teaches nursery school for years and years and years. And last year, she did what she always does. She has to get these children to understand the Christmas story. So she starts in September, going over who everybody was at the Nativity, Mary and Joseph and so forth. And she brings the figures in and puts together a creche. And every day she goes over it, and so that they know exactly what Christmas is all about. She practices all the carols. And the last day, half day before Christmas vacation begins, she gives every one of the little children a very special piece of paper and some crayons and says, now you're going to draw the nativity scene. We're going to wrap it up for your parents for Christmas. And so they work all morning. One little boy last year, Peter, she was worried about because he didn't seem to be paying any attention through any of the stories or any of this. And she walked around finally to look at everybody's picture, and some of them, of course, you know, as a teacher, you never say, oh, what is that? You just say, oh, how interesting, tell me about it. But she saw some very nice pictures and some that were absolutely not to be recognized, but they were the child's best effort and parents were going to be happy. She kind of hated to go to Peter because she didn't know what he would draw. She got to his desk and he had the most perfect picture of the Nativity. Everyone was there and in scale. Mary and Joseph and the cattle and the donkey and the shepherds and the sheep and the star and the angel. And over here were the way over with the wise men still making their way with the camels. And she looked at it and she said, Peter, this is just wonderful. It's wonderful. And he said, thank you, Sister Mary Alice. She said, Peter, I have to ask you though. I know everybody here. It's wonderful. Who's that fat little boy with the baseball cap that's standing next to Mary looking into the crib? He said, Sister Mary Alice, that's Round John Virgin. Ka-ching.
Right. On the spot, we have a home viewer, but let me do this first. What's the most dangerous Christmas amphibian? Mistletoad. Never mind. I am so sorry. Yes, we have a home viewer. Welcome to That's What She Said.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Oh, yeah, I just want to say that it's such a delightful show tonight.
Oh, well, thank you.
It is. It's very nice, and the music and the singing. And you girls have such interesting subjects, you know, to talk about all the time.
We try.
Okay, well, I just want to say it's a very nice show. Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you so very much.
Oh, you're welcome. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. And if anybody wants to suggest things for us to talk about, you can visit That's What She Said Online. Not online, but the whole title is That's What She Said Online.com. Communicate to us that way or through Facebook at That's What She Said. We're one of the That's What She Said's, many of them. But or through She Tweets to Me on Twitter. So you can, if you want to tell us to talk about something, we'll talk about it. If we think it's worthy. but anyway, let's see. Oh, it's time for the tradition. Surprise topic. Tonight it is Ellen.
Okay.
Uh-oh, well, she has visual aids.
Yes, yes, yes. Music is such an important part, obviously, of our show, of the holiday. And we've been hearing Christmas songs since mid-October. And I'm just wondering if we are really listening. And so I've developed a little quiz. I'm going to give you a line from a Christmas song, and I'd like you to give me the next line and then tell me the song that it comes from. Oh. And of course, you can play at home as well. Uh-oh. Okay, we're going to start with an easy one. Bells on bobtails ring.
Making spirits bright.
And it's from?
Jingle Bells.
Okay.
Jingle Bells.
Please have snow and mistletoe.
And presents under the tree.
And it's from?
White Christmas. Christmas. No, no, no. I'll be home for Christmas.
I'll be home for Christmas.
I know that Christmas in the title.
But do you recall?
The most famous reindeer of all.
Right, Rudolph. Okay. He was made of snow, but the children know
how he came to life one day.
And it's Frosty the Snowman. The Snowman. Okay.
I like this surprise topic.
Faithful friends who are dear to us.
Gather near to us once more.
And it's from?
Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
Very good. Okay.
I'm no good. What song?
You don't have to tell us. They're all set. Talking loudly enough, you don't have to. Okay.
My college finals like this.
Later on, we'll conspire.
As we sit by the fire, walking in a winter wonderland.
As we dream by the fire. Oh, right, right, but winter wonderland. Long lay the world.
In sin and error pining.
Right.
Oh, holy night.
Oh, holy night. Very good. Ring-a-ling, hear them ring.
Christmas bells.
Ring. With him playing in the back, I can't get
this.
Soon it will be Christmas.
Soon it will be
Sheila.
Christmas Day.
Sheila! Right? Yeah. Sheila!
And what was the song?
Oh, man.
Silver Bells.
Silver Bells. Very good.
I love that song.
I only have to say
yes.
It's a lousy movie, but a good song. Yeah. Dancing and prancing in Jingle Bell Square.
In a frosty air.
Very good.
Jingle Bell Rock.
Jingle Bell Rock, right. And decorations of red on a green Christmas tree.
Oh, I know this. Uh-oh, you're gonna decorations of
all
red.
All of us.
Christmas tree.
But I'll have a blue
Christmas.
It is blue Christmas, but the line is decorations of red on a green Christmas tree.
Won't be the same, dear, if you're,
not here,
with me.
Right, right, right. Elvis rules, right?
Oh no, I snorted.
You have to do the Elvis drawl too.
From all of us, good tidings we bring.
To you and your kin.
Your kin. And that's from We Wish You a Merry Christmas.
Which we do.
Okay.
We wish you all a Merry Christmas.
That's it.
Oh my goodness.
That's it.
We were pretty darn good.
You're very good, and I'm sure our audience was too.
Now, Jamie, could you bring another chair over here? Because we have a special guest joining us now. She was with us last year, and darn it, she was just so much fun. We thought we'd bring her back because it's that time of year, and you know she needs a break from all her wifely duties up in the North Pole. So please welcome Mrs. Claus.
Yay!
Hi, Mrs.
Hello, ladies.
Mrs. Claus, do you have a first name?
Mrs.
Oh, okay. All right. I've often wondered that. Santa just goes, Mrs.
Yes. Pretty much, that's what happens.
Oh my goodness gracious.
How did you get here today, Mrs. Claus? Because last year you skated into our studio.
Ah.
I did, that is true.
Well, she got
today
snow this year.
I rode my bicycle.
Bicycle?
Yes, I did.
Oh my goodness gracious.
Starting from where? The North Pole?
Yes, yes. And it is quite a trick to ride your bicycle on the ice.
And across.
It takes years, hundreds of years of practice.
How old are you? I shouldn't ask a lady
her age. Oh, you
never ask a lady. I can't even believe that came out of your mouth.
Oh, well, you know.
Mrs. Claus, what's he like at this time of the year? It's got to be rather stressful living in your house with all those elves.
It is. It is very stressful at our house. And so to take some of that stress away, I try to stay out of his way. That's the best thing to do.
What are you packaging things? Are you helping him with things? Are you just...
I bake cookies.
Okay.
I have been baking cookies with my helpers for the last 72 hours straight.
Wait a second. What the heck are we all baking cookies to leave for Santa if you're giving him cookies?
Well, you know, his audience has a certain expectation for his physique. Yeah. And so I have to keep that, you know, up to par. I can't disappoint him, just the audience, just like Dolly Parton. You know, there is a certain amount of work that has to be done, and that is my duty. I promised that on our wedding day. Well, keep him fat.
Well, I would like, if I may, because it's such a special occasion having you here, can we do a song?
Absolutely.
Oh, my goodness. Let me get untethered here. My goodness.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, take that from me.
Got it.
Let's go over here and sing a little holiday treat. Oh, it's Mrs. Claus. This is wonderful.
They're do-si-do-ing.
Always a treat coming here.
It is. It's a treat having you here. That's right. I'm taller than you tonight.
Today you are.
It's the heels. All right. Oh, look, he segued right into it.
He did. He's very good.
Hey, you know what? The weather outside is frightful.
But the fire is so delightful.
And since we no place to go, let it snow.
Let it snow. Let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping.
No, and I brought some corn for Poopity Poppin'.
The lights are turned way down low.
Look really bright. But let it snow.
Let it snow. Let it snow.
When we finally kiss goodnight.
How I hate going out in the storm.
It's stormy. But with you there to hold me tight.
All the way home you'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying.
Oh, yes. And my dear, we're still goodbying.
But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.
Thank you so much.
Oh,
I love you. I love you, Mrs. Claus, and thank you again, Sid, for your wonderful job. Let's go.
Okay.
Oh, you just, yes, just stay with us for the rest of the show.
Certainly.
That's fine. Oh, yes.
Yes. Oh, yes. Oh, well, I guess we need this back here. We're going to bring back on Colorblind, and they're going to... Indeed, they're going to sing and we're going to join in. What? Aren't you rushing things, Jamie? Well, come on, ladies. We run a tight ship around here. Should we all gather around? All right. All right. Excuse me, I've just walked in front of the camera.
Always love
it. All right. Sing us it. Sing us out.
Have another
sing one. Sing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. O'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun!
way.
Scene.
Now the grounds are white. Go do it while you're young. Take the girls along and sing this sleighing song. Just get Bob to obey. Do 40 at his speed. Pitch him to an open sleigh and let you take the lead. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Ah, fine. Thank you very, very, very much for joining us tonight. Let's see, where are we time-wise? About four?
Three.
Okay, 3 minutes. Well, heck, we can have our last little things. I want to remind you, I want to thank Colorblind for being here with us.
Wonderful. Yes.
Oh, indeed. And Sid Watts at the piano, and yes, and Mrs. Claus, of course, and all of you, all of you for joining us weekly. And if this is your first time, come back.
And Jane, we're going to have the recipes for the cookies and the glug on the website.
On the website.
Yes.
Excellent, yes.
Martha, why don't you explain a little bit about the glug?
The glug is a Scandinavian Christmas drink. It has red wine and port and brandy and rum and cloves and orange, and it's hot and very strong, and it just warms you up. I think the Swedes have a very good idea.
I couldn't wait to get here for some of that.
Well, you know, after bicycling on all of that ice, it's you need some glue.
That's exactly what you need.
Well, you could stop at Scandinavia on your way down and then head over. We want to also remind you about our special January edition of That's What She Said, which we'll be taping on at Papillon Brasserie on January 10th. If you would like to be a part of that, I'll let you all grab a pencil. Okay. That's 610-376-0601 to join us for that evening. It's going to be fun. I don't know. Again, it's a prefix. I don't know what he's charging. We'll get that information and put it up on the website, too. We'll put everything up on the website. That's what we do. We put things up on the website. It's wonderful.
And our next show will actually be on Wednesday.
Yes. Wednesday right after that. Hold on.
January.
The third Wednesday.
If you've ever tried to use an iPhone with gloves, it's really like...
It's like the 24th.
Would that be right?
Oh, wrong one.
No, that wouldn't be the...
Hold on. We're
getting there.
22nd. Oh,
here, hit 22nd? December.
22nd?
Now scroll... Christmas, there we go.
New Year's Day is the first Wednesday.
22nd.
So the 22nd. The 22nd of... February.
January.
January.
January. What happened?
What happened?
We
don't
know
what's going on.
That's the third Wednesday.
Oh, it is.
Oh,
because the first is a Wednesday. Yes, 15th. So it's we party on the 10th and we broadcast on the 15th.
And that will not be a live show. Right?
Well, we don't know about that.
Oh.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you and Merry Christmas to our wonderful studio, to BCTV, to Amber Bernhard, Joan Freeman, Scott Shanneman, and John Ferdina. Yes.
Thank you.
Got it.
Thank you all.
And again, thank you all for joining us and keeping us so warm in your heart. And
jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Merry Christmas, happy holidays to all of you. Thank you so much, and God bless, and from That's What She Said, we love you. We love each other. We love everybody. See you next time.
Season of love.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Thanks.
Shh.